Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with the Dell EMC PowerEdge R660 Server. We just recently reviewed the R650 Server as it took quite a while to get one of those in-house. This latest 1U R660 has similar characteristics as the R650 that make it one of Dell's most popular workhorse servers. You can see that video here. Like the previous generation, the R660 will support up to 3 GPUs. Between support for up to 2 fourth generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, plus DDR5 memory, PCIe 5.0, this platform delivers the goods on performance. Given the newness of this system, there are a few contradictions in the documentation. Dell usually does some follow-up to correct those errors, which is one of the things I do appreciate. The Sapphire Rapids CPUs do support up to 60 cores each, but this platform is limited to those with up to 56 physical cores and 112 virtual threads per CPU, even though the thermal design power range is listed at up to 350 watts. At that TDP, there is a 60-core CPU listed. It also supports a mix of PCIe 5.0 and PCIe 4.0 in those expansion slots. This platform is designed for flexibility, uses to include high-performance computing, hyper-converged infrastructures, plus standard networking applications, just to name a few. The general layout of the front panel includes 5 distinct storage areas compatible with SAS, SATA, or NVMe storage devices. In the 10-bay option, each of those 5 storage areas has 2 drive bays. The 8-bay chassis leaves the center section open with 4 storage bays to either side. This is also the case with the optional E3.S storage option, which can house 14 to 16 7mm EDSFF drives, also leaving the center section without drive bays. Featuring a thin profile, those E3.S storage devices enable a 25 to 50% increase in storage density compared to NVMe U.2 SSDs. These will eventually push out the standard SSD form factor with wider adoption of PCIe 5.0. As a matter of note, on the previous generation 8-bay R650, there was a small media bay in the upper right side that supported 2 additional drive bays, taking the number of drive bays to 10. With the center section empty on the R660, the system gains improved airflow over the CPUs compared to the R650. The EDSFF option on the R660 requires an optional backplane to go with the optional drive format. Maximum storage capacity is listed at up to 154 terabytes for the SFF 10-bay version and up to 123 terabytes for the SFF 8-bay option. The optional rear drive cage provides 2 more SAS, SATA, or Gen 5 NVMe bays and will provide up to 30 terabytes of additional storage. Capacity for the EDSFF version is not listed. One more thing not listed is support for 3.5-inch storage bays, which apparently are not a thing on the R660. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge R660 server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the cost of a system listed or one that you can configure on our site that's valued at $5,000 or more. It's a pretty sweet deal. Just click that link to see more information on this system, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video, itcreations.com. On the right side of the chassis, the power on button with a USB 2.0 port and iDRAC Direct micro AB USB port below that. On the left, you get either the large blue button for system health and system ID indicator, or a smaller blue button on top for system health and system ID, and a white iDRAC quick sync button below that for wireless connection to the system using an Android or iOS enabled smartphone or tablet. Using quick sync with the OpenManage mobile app, you can quickly access system inventory, the Dell lifecycle controller logs or system logs, system health status, and you can also configure iDRAC, BIOS, and networking parameters. There are a few other features too: keyboard video mouse, KVM viewer, and virtual machine. Besides those buttons, there are a few telltale LEDs providing information on drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe indicator. On the back of the system, the PSUs are located to either side of the chassis and are available in a number of different capacities depending on the configuration. All of them are hot swap and offer full redundancy. To the left of the primary PSU is a small cage for the boot optimized storage subsystem, or BOSS. It features 2 NVMe 80mm M.2 drives with a PCIe Gen 3 x 4 host interface to support the operating system. The drives are hot swap and easily accessible with a built-in controller that supports RAID levels of 0 and 1 for redundancy. RAID can be enabled through BIOS or iDRAC, and there are actually 3 different BOSS controllers: monolithic, modular, or modular ET. The monolithic carrier, like the version we have on the back of this system, has a plug-in controller with 2 rear accessible and removable M.2 caddies that plug into the carrier. A modular controller has the 2 M.2 drives that connect to a circuit board, which in turn plugs directly into a dedicated slot on the motherboard. The modular ET controller is for extreme temperature applications. Starting on the bottom left, there is an optional LAN on motherboard card with 2 gigabit Ethernet NIC ports for network connectivity. Beside that, an optional OCP 3.0 NIC card can be installed using the internal mezzanine card slot. Next, a system ID button with integrated LED, and then another removable circuit board, which features a dedicated RJ45 iDRAC 9 Ethernet port for remote management of the system. 2 USB 2.0 ports and a VGA port. Above that will either be 3 PCIe slots connecting to the internal risers, or optionally, there could be a drive cage with 2 2.5-inch drive bays that will bring your PCIe slot options down from 3 ports to only a single port. iDRAC, or Integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, provides secure local and remote access to the system either in-band or out-of-band. In this case, the system comes pre-installed with iDRAC 9 Direct. Hopefully by this point, our iDRAC video has been released for a more comprehensive view of the capabilities. Check that link there. The system can also be upgraded to Enterprise or Data Center license, both of which offer more functionality to manage your system. Basic features include full-time health monitoring, firmware updates, deployment plus BIOS and RAID configuration, system inventory, and diagnostics. With the Express version, as on this system, you also get email alerting and remote OS deployment. iDRAC can access the system whether the OS is installed or not. There are many features, in fact, up to 5,000 system parameters that are monitored, so you will find a wealth of information there. You could also go with Dell's Open Manage Utility for even more tools, but that's a whole other can of worms. Back to the hardware. I mentioned earlier the 4th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors support for PCIe 5.0. This is also a big boost in performance for NVMe storage devices because they too utilize the PCIe bus. Not to mention PCIe-based I/O devices like Broadcom, Intel, NVIDIA, and Mellanox InfiniBand options supporting data transfer speeds of up to 200 gigabits per second. PCIe 5.0 offers 2 times the bandwidth compared to PCIe 4.0, which is great for data-hungry applications. 32 DDR5 DIMM slots on the system board can be outfitted with 3DS registered DIMMs or RDIMMs for up to 8 terabytes of maximum memory. Memory speeds supported include 4800 megatransfer per second. That assumes all slots are filled with 256 gigabyte 3DS RDIMM memory modules. Unlike the R650, this platform does not support Intel persistent memory, which on the R650 platform provided up to 12 terabytes when mixed with RDIMM modules. Like the R650, however, our R660 does support optional direct liquid cooling, or DLC, which is a rack solution that requires manifolds and a cooling distribution unit, and probably best left for a data center deployment. With up to 3 PCIe slots supported on the risers in the back, there are options for full length, half length, low profile, x16, x8, and even a few PCIe Gen 4 options. The slots in the system also support bifurcation for certain uses like support of multiple PCIe-based M.2 NVMe drives. A mezzanine card slot on the motherboard supports an optional OCP 3.0 card for additional network connections. Up to 3 GPUs are supported, only one of which is currently listed. The NVIDIA Ampere A2 PCIe-based GPU features 60-watt power draw with 16 gigabytes, passive cooling, and a single-width low profile. This card is an entry-level inference card for machine learning, AI applications, and intelligent video analytics, offering excellent performance, low power, and a small footprint for highly parallel computing tasks. The NVIDIA T4 is also an option at that 75-watt threshold. The Dell PowerEdge R660 server offers flexibility, performance, and scalability to suit a number of business-critical applications or to add more capacity to your existing network. It's designed to play nice with your other network hardware. The funny thing is, if this server was a car, it would be like going to the dealer and browsing their collection of car chassis without an engine, transmission, interior, or wheels. Given the cost to outfit a server, even at 1U, it's like buying a supercar, a Lambo or a Bentley, if you wanted maximum capacity. Everything is an add-on for servers, and it can quickly add up. If you want the best pricing, try IT Creations. We have what you need and can configure it to your specifications, so you can place it on the front line right out of the box. If you have any questions, place them in the comment section below. If you made it this far, hit that subscribe button. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.